Hola, what's going on, guys? I've been thinking for a while now. I wanted to start a series for the channel, and the series is going to be Warzone meme reviews. So make sure you guys give me feedback. Let me know if you like it. I'm going to try to grow the channel from here, and I got my streaming set up. So I'm not going to do all that. Please subscribe, hit the like button. Like, if you guys are going to do it, you're going to do it because that's all I am. All right, let's hop right into it. This first one, you think of what I'm thinking, partner? Aim for Boneyard. And then they're dead on impact as soon as their feet touch the ground. I don't know about Boneyard. I don't know about a lot of places. I mean, Superstore used to be one of those ones that was kind of, I had trouble with landing there. Also Prison. I mean, I've been playing for a couple of years now, and I just don't have a lot of luck at Prison for whatever reason. All right, this one says you have $4,500. These are the choices: A, UAV; B, revive teammates; C, self-revive; or D, precision airstrike. I know we've all been in that boat where you just can't make your mind up and you're there, you're burning time. Maybe a guy's aiming at you because you had it in your head, I'm gonna run to this store, jump out the building or whatever, run out, hit the store, and then you're there contemplating what to get like you didn't already. It's like when you go to a drive-thru and you stare at the menu and then you get the same thing you always do. It's like that. So that one's pretty good. Cash me in the gulag. How about that? That's pretty funny because more times than not, when I kill somebody, they're like, they yell something like, I'll be back, bitch, or you're gonna die. Like, all right, well, we'll see. You know what I mean? We'll see. And then a lot of times, I mean, I don't know for certain because I don't always catch the name tags, but a lot of times if I kill somebody and then their team kills me, I'm in a gulag. So we died like within, you know, 5-10 seconds of each other. You know, I take it personal and I'm like, I gotta win this gulag just so that guy I killed don't come back. You know what I mean? So that's another good one. Rumors of a new Warzone map. My hard drive. Sweating bullets. It's a lot of times, not just with Warzone, but other games as well, where it updates, or I think it's updating at night, and then I see the next day that it paused because there's not enough room. So then you got to go back through and delete everything. I got the 500 gigabyte PS4 right now, and I think I only got like 4 games on there, but I also have external hard drive that I got just recently, so I actually have like 2K on there, GTA, even though I don't really play GTA like that, you know, like Red Dead Redemption, those kind of games, just so that I can have them without, because sometimes I'll be in the mood to play a game and then I can't play them the night I want to play them. I gotta wait till the next day because I gotta let them download. So yeah, that's atrocious. You claimed he was one shot. His full HP armor determined that was a lie. Yeah, that's funny. A lot of times people are like, oh, he's one shot, or I cracked him blue, and then I push him, you know, he's one shot, and I break him blue, and he didn't have time to heal up. So I think that's people just wanting you to get over there and help, maybe pick him up, but which I have no problem doing. But if they say he's one shot, chances are he ain't really one shot. When your friend who's been peering offline joins your group, well, 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 if it ain't the invisible cunt. That's funny. You know, I hate to admit it, but sometimes you just gotta show offline. You know, it's all good to play with people and stuff like that, but and I respect being honest with somebody, but how do you really tell your friend, like, hey, I don't feel like playing with you, or hey, you talk too much, or you bug me, you make the game not fun, you know? So you can't really say that. It's just easier to appear offline and no harm, no foul type thing. Which leads into this one. When you switch your online status to appear offline, Bravo 6 going dark. Yeah, that's how it feels. Sometimes that is how it feels. Here's another one, funny enough. When you're appearing offline, you get put into a match with your friend who's also appearing offline. You shouldn't be here. Neither should you. I'm sure that's happened. I mean, it's had to have happened. Maybe I feel like you would just see it in the kill feed if you were really paying that close attention. But to be put on the same team, I don't know. I mean, with all the different lobbies and all the different teams in each lobby, I'm not saying it has never happened, but man, that would be awkward. This one is funny. This one is really funny. One of the funniest ones I think I've seen tonight. It says, when you have to buy the whole squad back in Warzone. And then it says, I am never going to financially recover from this. Well, it doesn't say whole squad, but that's what they mean. That's funny. That is funny. But you know what? It doesn't matter. I mean, you could get all the self-revives and all the precision airstrikes and gas masks and ammo boxes you want. But at the end of the day, you're going to get a lot further with three guys coming back with pistols than you are all kitted up yourself. So I know that feeling, though. Like, damn, I done saved all this money or whatever, and now you bums died, and I got to get you back. Like, come on, gommel up. Hey, I have a friend, Bird, who is just like this. This is him. It says, when you're the guy who just loots, points out enemies, and then dies. It ain't much, but it's honest work. I know that's right. That's why I tell him, like, he's the call-out guy. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not saying he's trash. He's pretty good, but that's, like, those are his, like, that's what he specializes in, right? That's his specialty, is them call-outs, because, you know, and he's good with them, too, because I don't know how he does it, so I can't pretend to know, but it's almost like having somebody spectating the other team for you. He's magical with it, you know? He's like, he's up the stairs, around the corner, in the room over here, and you know right where he is, so that's funny. This one goes back to that one earlier, me deciding which game to uninstall every time Modern Warfare has a massive update. It's just the sad reality of it. I mean, unless you get an external hard drive or you get a PS4 Pro or a PS5. And I mean, even that, the external hard drives aren't a bad option because you could just plug them in and unplug them. I mean, make sure that you disconnect them through the menu before you unplug them because you corrupt all your stuff. But it's actually a really, I wouldn't say convenient, but it's a way to manage it, you know? So I would, if you guys don't, I would look into that. Me and the boys in Warzone after finding $7 total on 35 loot boxes. You know, that's like a hit or a miss for me, because some games it'll feel like I've just ran through so many loot boxes. I've done this, that, and we can't get up money for the life of us, you know? And then it's other games where I like look down, I'm like, oh man, I got 18K and he's got 12 and he's got 20. So I don't know. I don't know if that's in my head or just the luck of the draw, but it is weird how it goes from such far ends of the spectrum, you know what I mean? Like, there's no real middle ground. It's like either you're rich or you're broke. But I think that about does it for today's Warzone meme review, the first Warzone meme review. You guys let me know if you like it, and I mentioned that earlier, but if I get people saying that was cool and, you know what I mean, they enjoy watching them, then obviously I'm gonna keep making more because I have fun doing this kind of stuff, and hopefully we can make the channel grow, you know what I mean? But all right, guys, I'll catch you next time. Peace.